oppositions. Whatever you ask, believe that you shall receive, and it will be given to you. What an apostolate Jesus exercised on the cross amidst his agonies, praying for sinners, sending up his cry, I thirst. He saved the world more with his passion and death rather than with his preaching and our manner of speaking. See, a real apostolate is the one which grafts itself, becomes one with and conforms itself to the apostolate of Jesus. It is inspired by the same incentive, the glory of God and peace to men. Many among those who call themselves apostles do not strive for the greater glory of God. They are noisy cymbals, chiming bells, wind which puffs one up, but then all is dispersed. Many, too many, seek their own interests rather than those of Jesus Christ. The man of God judges things under the light which comes from above. He understands the part they play in God's redemptive plan more than their exterior aspect. Failures do not dishearten him. God can be glorified by his very humiliation. His aim, his intention is always God and souls. Hence, every apostolate requires ever more supernatural characteristics, efficacy, and vitality. God is everything. The souls are in God's arms. My dear children, with whom I am in labor again until Christ is formed in you. Galatians 4:19. When God builds them work entirely from his hands, he reduces all to impotence. Then he sets to work. When the ego is annihilated, God lives. With Jesus Christ's program, one works with him, in him, through him. And when God is with us, who will be against us? We cannot have a greater security than that the Lord worked with them from the preaching. This apostle will be able to do all. The works that I do, he also shall do, and greater than these shall he do. John 14:12. Mary is the holiest of all, hence she is the first apostle. In fact, she is the apostle. To the mystical body of Christ, that is, to the church, Mary made the principal contribution to her sanctity, a vigor and exuberance of abundant life. Her fullness, full of grace, overflowed upon all the souls, from St. John the Evangelist to St. John Bosco, from the martyrs to the virgins, from the popes to the pious laborer. Christ is the life. From the head, this life descended to the members, and every day he vivifies new souls in baptism, in the Eucharist, in penance. These souls live of Christ.